So here we'll see different numericals related with timer IC, IC555. So let's go through the first problem. It says design an stable multivibrator using IC555 for given frequency of oscillation is 5 kilohertz. So what we'll do, let's say this is our circuit diagram. As we know, there are R1, R2 and capacitors. So it will decide charging and discharging path. Okay. Before going to this, let's see the formula for frequency of oscillation. Okay. See. So here is the formula. And similarly, if we see the formula for, we can say, duty cycle, we have 2R2. Now here we have a flexibility. That is, the duty cycle is not given. We are free to assume anything. So for the simplification, what we'll do, we'll choose R1 equals to R2 so that the designing will be simple. Let's say R. Okay. So it gives us the D is equal to simply 2R upon 3R, that is 2/3. Okay, so we'll get something 2/3 of 100%. Now, with the given frequency 5 kilohertz, let's say F equals to 5 kilohertz means 5000, that is equal to 1.44 upon R1 is equal to R2. So we'll get simply R1 plus 2R1, that is 3R1 and C. Or we can say our formula or simplification will be much, much simple. So simply, I can say R1C is equal to 1.44 upon 3 into 5000. So we'll have to assume one of the value. So what we'll assume? We should choose a value of capacitor. As we know that the variable capacitors are costly. Now this is some another type of problem, that design an stable multivibrator using timer IC555. Now here what we see, on time and off time is given, and it is asking for calculate frequency and duty cycle. So let us design how to get a T on and T off. We can calculate the duty cycle and frequency from this value itself. But first, we'll have to design this parameter. I'll use the formula for T on equals to 0.693 R1 plus R2 into C. So we see this formula for T on. Similar to this, we'll have the formula for T off. That is, it will discharge through only R2. So we can say the formula for this will become 0.693 R2C. Now this total of this T1 plus T2 will be the capital T or time period. Okay, so that we can get as T equals to T1 plus T2. And from this, we can calculate the duty cycle as well as frequency. If I take T equals to T1 plus T2, I can get frequency as 1 upon T. Similarly, duty cycle, it will be the ratio of on time T1 to total time T. So if I can get these values, I can get the value of this one. So as I know, T1, it is given 5 milliseconds, and this as 3 milliseconds. So it gives me 8 milliseconds. So F equals to 1 by 8 of millisecond. Okay. So it will be 1000. And the value of this will be equals to 1 by 8 into 1000. So it gives me 125. So 125 hertz is the frequency. And similarly, duty cycle, T1 is 5 millisecond and total time period is 8 millisecond. So it will give me value. If I calculate this, 5 divided by 8, I'll get a 0.625. Or I can say D equals to 62.5%. So in this way, I can get the value of this one. Now comes the designing. Now we have T1, formula for T1 as well as T2. Now from which value we should start? If we observe T1, here we have three unknown variable, whereas in T2, or we can say T off, we have two unknown variables. So we should start from T off. So T off is given 3 millisecond. So we'll start from that one. So T off, we can say it is given 3 millisecond, which is equal to 0.693 R2C. Now here we'll assume some values of capacitor. Let's say C is equal to 1 microfarad. So that should give me the value of R2 is equal to, let's calculate this one. So it is 3 millisecond. So 3 millisecond divided by 1 microfarad, it will be 3 divided by 10 to power minus 3. It means 3 into 1000. So it will become 3000 divided by 0.693. So I'll take divided by 0.693. So it will give me a value equals to, let's say, 4329. So it is coming out to be 4.3 kilo ohm. Okay. And now we have a value of C and R2 from T1 or T on, which is given as 5 millisecond. We can calculate both values, R1 plus R2 into C. R2 is given 4.32K into capacitor, that is 1 microfarad. Okay, let's do a calculation. So R1 value we have to calculate. So it will be 0.693 R1 plus 0.693 to 4.32 into kilo ohm is 10 to power 3 into 1 microfarad means 10 to power minus 6. Similarly, this capacitor will be multiplied by here also. So we'll have here 10 to power minus 6. Okay. So in this way, this 5 millisecond, 0.693 R1 into 10 to power minus 6 equals to 5 millisecond, that is 5 into 10 to power minus 3 minus 0.693 into 4.32 10 to power minus 3. 10 to power 3 into 10 to power minus 6, 10 to power minus 3. So I can take this 10 to power minus 3 common, you can say. So 5 minus 0.693 into 4.32. So that will give us a value as 5 minus 0.693 into 4.32. That into 10 to power minus 3 divided by this 0.10 to power minus 6 and 0.693. So eventually I'll get divided by 0.693. And if I divide it by 10 to power minus 6, so 10 to power minus 3 divided by 10 to power minus 6 means into 10 to power 3. So I'll multiply it with the 1000. So I'll get value as 2895. So R1 I am getting as 2895, that is 2.895 kilo. So now I have a value of R1 here R2 and capacitor C. And already we have calculated the duty cycle and frequency. So our design is complete with all these values, 2.895 and point, you can say 2.895 kilo and 4.32 kilo. Suppose precisely it is required, we can take if it is roughly required, we can take some standard values of resistor near to this one, like 4.7k. I can take here, I can take roughly you can say 2.7, like this standard value. But if it is precisely needed, what should one do? So now I'll write down the values of all the component. R1 is equal to 2.895 k and R2 equals to, it is 4.32 k, and C is equal to, we have taken 1 microfarad. Now how do we make it a precise one? So we can make, let us say, if this is my 555 IC, okay, and if I am connecting, say, this 8 and 4 VCC and reset, I have connected to VCC. In between this, I need to connect 2.895 of resistor. So what should I do? I can do a variable resistor that can be preset or pot depending on the application. So I can take a pot, but instead of taking only pot, I'll take one resistor in series with variable resistor. Okay, it is for the actual design. Similarly, when I need to take between 6 and 2 another resistor which should be of value 4.32k, so instead of taking only pot, I'll take one resistor in series with a variable resistor. So that value we should take 1k, let's say 1k, and this can be a pot of 10k which will adjust to, let's say, 1.895, so that 1 plus 1.895k will become a 2.895k. Similarly, R2 will take a pot of 10k which can be adjusted to 4.32k, which when we added with this one, it will become, sorry, 3.32k, so that it will become 4.32k. Why we have taken a 1k resistor in series with this one? Let's say we are moving this wiper of this pot. There is a possibility that it can get a short circuit. Short circuit in a sense, zero resistance. If there is no minimum assured safe resistor in series with this one, there is a probability, there is a chance that a heavy current will flow through this and it may destroy the 555, or even it can malfunction. So it is recommended while designing that you should use a some safer value of resistor in series with variable resistor, so that it will assure that it will not malfunction. So I hope the things are clear and you can take the output from this one as usual. 5, you can bypass it with a capacitor of 0.01 microfarad. So whatever the value, whatever it is expected that we should have a T on as 5 milliseconds and T off as 3 milliseconds, we will get from these values of resistor and capacitor as 1 microfarad. So now we'll see some variation in the problem of designing astable multivector using the timer IC. So here we have to design astable multivibrator using IC555. Now this is, you can say, the waveform which is we require, and as it is given the 75% duty cycle and 500 hertz, so we'll move with this one. So we know the frequency formula for 555 astable multivibrator and duty cycle. So let us see, we have F equals to 1.44 upon R1 plus 2 R2 into C. Similarly, we have duty cycle equals to R1 plus R2 upon R1 plus 2 R2. It is given 75%, that is 3/4. So will cross multiply this one, so we'll get 4R1 plus 4R2 equals to 3R1 plus 6R2. That will give us a R1 equal to 2R2. So here we have got a relation that R1 and R2. So here we'll be get tempted to choose particular value of R2 and we can get a value of R1, but we should not follow this path. Why? Because when we put these values into the frequency of oscillation for 500 Hertz, that value of capacitor, we may get something which is not, we can say, a standard value. So better we'll get this relation and we'll try to put it into the frequency formula. So we have frequency formula as 1.44 R1 plus 2R2. Now I'll put R1 equals to 2R2. So I can get 2R2 plus 2R2 into C, which is we want a of 500 Hertz. So with this, we can go for calculation. So what we get, if I do this calculation, I'll get a 4R2. Okay. So simply, I can say if I put this 4R2C equals to 1.44 upon 500 and R2 equals to 1.44 into 4 into 500 into value of C. Now here we have a flexibility to choose the value of capacitor. So I can say by experience that as this frequency is very low, time period will be large, so I must take a value of capacitor something near about, you can say, let's say 0. microfarad. Okay, so let's see with this what value I am getting. So 1.44 45 is 20, 2 into 10 to power 3, C is 0.1, 10 to power minus 6. So simply I get something sort of like this, 2 into 0.1, 0.2, and this will be 10 to power minus 3. So I must take 1.44 divided by 0.2 into 1000. So let us do that one. So I can get 1.44 divided by 0.2, okay, and into 1000, I am getting 7200 value. So I'll put R2 equals to 72 ohm, that is 7.2 kilo. So I have now value of R2 and I know the relation between R1 and R2. R1 is twice of this one. So now the next value I got, R1 equals to 2R2 equals to, you can get 7.2 into 2. So I'll get R1 equals to 14.4 kilo. So I have the value of R1, I have the value of R2 and the value of capacitor. So my design is now ready and I can design the stable multivector for this one. Now if at all it is needed to connect this to a LED, so always remember, whenever we connect the output to LED for the low frequency stable motor, in order to limit the current, we must connect a resistor in between, which should be grounded and it is to be given to the output. So now how to calculate the value of this current limiting resistor? So for general LEDs, we should have the idea that the voltage across red, yellow, green, normally this V LED is approximately equals to 2 volt. It revolves around, some are 1.9, some are 2.1, 2, like that one. And the current which is to be allowed through this LED ranges from 10 milliampere to 50 milliampere. So in the 50 milliampere, the brightness will be more, in the 10 milliampere, the brightness will be less. But normally for calculation or designing,
we take this value as a 10 milliampere. So let us say if I am using VCC equals to 5 volt, so how should I calculate? Let's say this is 555 pin 3. I'm connecting here LED in series with resistor. So we know here when it is high, I'll get a VCC voltage, and this is grounded. So VCC is connected across this one. Now we have that VLED will be there approximately equals to 2 volt, and ILED I must take up to 10 milliampere. So with this, I get the value of resistor as this total voltage minus the voltage across LED, VCC or V minus VLED upon, we can say, the current which we want to allow through this LED. So simply, if I take a 5 volt and if I am saying 2 volt across the LED, and if I am putting 10 milliampere I am allowing, I'll get a value as 5 minus 2 is 3, 20, 10. So this will be simply 0.3 to 10 to power 3, or I can say 300 ohm. So standard value I can take as 330 ohm, which is normally used. Many a times you might have seen for VCC equal to 5 volt or TTL logic, 100 ohm is used. So we can say the current will be more in this case, in the 100 ohm. So we can use like that one. Similarly, if we are taking the VCC of 9 volt, if we do a calculation like VCC minus VLED upon ILED to get the value of resistor, so we can choose roughly 1K will be sufficient for 9 volts. So in this way, one can do a calculation.